holy crap, like when people like see me, they'll like, how will they like, will they change their perspective of me, or will they say something else? Or I wasn't sure what to, how to feel about it.
There was definitely a really strong fear that I felt because of how my dad would react to it, because it revolves around my initial and eternal love of my dad, how much I love him, how much he meant to me growing up, and how much it was an incredible challenge in my life to see him doing a lot of bad things and tearing our family apart. So yeah, it's been interesting, kind of putting the pieces back together of our relationship since then.
I spent a lot of years being really embarrassed about my family, and it's not because they're not wonderful people, but because I just felt like I was different from all of my friends.
It certainly helped me. It certainly helped that like I can share the story. It means I'm no longer underneath the crushing weight of silence.
I talk about things like my family facing things like homelessness, and there are things that, like, even my best friends from home didn't really know that I was going through at the time because I just didn't want to talk about it. My life is literally just like class, job, and extracurriculars. Like, that's all it is. And you get really caught up in that bubble and you worry more about your midterms and all that. And you forget that sometimes students here are more than just, like students trying to get good grades, graduate, go on to whatever they want to go on to.
I think that it's really liberating to come to college and be able to create yourself again. But I also think that there are core parts of people's identities that are lost in that, like, kind of rebirth.
It was just better, like to actually just have it all out, and it's been chill. Like a lot of people know about it now, and I have no problem with that. And I think it's important to be open and honest.
There is a culture on campus that, a culture of sensitivity, and that's a good thing. But sometimes that makes us wary to, I think that makes Carl's wary to breach serious issues in a non-academic setting.
I really like the term break the silence because there really is something that feels like breaking about it. It feels like you really are breaking a very physical thing. If I'm a guy and I never talk to girls about sexual harassment, well, I'm not gonna have an understanding of what masculinity means for me. If I'm white and I don't talk to people of color, well, I'm not gonna understand like how white oppression works. If I'm not mentally ill and I never talk to a mentally ill person, well, I'm not even going to understand how the words mentally ill don't even fully fit what it means to have some kind of a mental illness. It's bringing these things from silence into voice, from darkness into light, right? But it shouldn't stop there.
Some friendships opened up for me because I shared this really personal part of my story. I hung out with a lot of people afterwards, who then were like, "I really appreciated you sharing this. This is what I've been dealing with, and I haven't felt comfortable expressing that, but I do now."
I've got to meet and have deep conversations with people from all around the campus and the community, and it's connected me with alumni who have messaged me and all sorts of things that would have not have happened had I not done this project.
Some prospects are like, "Oh, I recognize you from that," and they think it's like really neat. Because some of them do come from like low-income backgrounds, so I'm like a Questbird student, so I sort of, I guess, reach out to low-income prospects, and so it's like, I guess, a way to kind of get them to see that Carleton is more than like a liberal arts college that's expensive with rich kids.
People who have read my story who've gone through abuse definitely got something from it. I know that I've gotten things from reading other people's stories that relate to my own.
It takes an immense amount of like bravery and courage to share, like to talk about things like substance abuse or like assault or things like that. Like, it takes an immense amount of courage to like talk about these things and then talk about it on such a public forum.
I'm ready for this. It's okay. Let's start the dialogue.
At the end of the day, we're all human, and there's nothing, the only barriers that we encounter, we create.